them anything at all. Jeremy Jacob knows about pirates because one day he was at the beach building a sand castle and minding his own business. A pirate ship sailed into view. Jeremy knew it was with its flag and skull and crossbow on it. And he could hear the pirates singing,
"Hey ho, blow the man down!"
They were well off key. Jeremy turned with all his staff. And he was busy studying the beach in front. Jeremy turned with all his lawn, and she was busy sledding his big sister with sunblock. So Jeremy went back to his sandcastle, but he kept an eye on the pirates. By then they were rowing to shore. The pirate had come out of the boat and yelled,
"Ahoy there, matey! Be this the Spanish Main?"
"No, this is North Beach."
"Shiver me timbers! We must have took a wrong turn at Bora Bora."
The pirate walked around Jeremy's sandcastle. He looked at the moat, then yelled back to his crew,
"Easy, Digger and Anson, go on to boot!"
"A good one to boot!"
"What's your name, matey?"
"Jeremy Jacob, sir."
"Well, Jeremy Jacob, you're looking a great beer and his crew. We've been needing a digger like yourself, or we've attested treasure to bear."
"Aye, treasure!"
"Coming with us."
"I don't think my mom and dad won't mind, as long as I get in time for my soccer practice tomorrow."
That's how Jeremy became a pirate. As soon as Jeremy was on board, Greybeard showed him a chest full of gold and jewels.
"Got to find a safe place for this here treasure. It's high time, and we're off!"
"We're off!"
Then they set sail.
There was plenty to do on board. The pirates taught Jeremy to sing sea shanties, the louder the better, and to say real pirate stuff like Landlubber and Scurvy Dog. By dinner time, Jeremy could speak pirate perfectly.
Jeremy also learned pirate manners. Greybeard promised his fist at the table and yelled,
"Down the hatch, me laddies!
Down the hatch!"
Redbeard gulped his food and yelled,
"Hand over the meat!
The meat!"
Nobody told us to finish our spinach. There wasn't any. Or to chew up our carrots. They weren't allowed on board. We talked with our mouthful and nobody said please or thank you.
After dinner, Jeremy tried to teach the pirates to play soccer. Baby kicked the ball and yelled,
"Our soccer!
Our soccer!"
And everyone dumped the ball at once and rolled right off the deck.
"After it, me hearties!"
"After it?"
They all fought over who would get the ball. It didn't matter anyways. The Cherokee won the swallow and go. So much for soccer.
By now, it was way past Jeremy's bedtime. They now went to the pirates to go to bed, take a bath, or brush their teeth. Maybe that's why their teeth are green. Pirates don't need to pajamas unless they want to. Pirates don't do anything they don't want to except for swallowing their decks.
"I want to be a pirate forever!"
But then, Jeremy found out what else pirates don't do.
"I couldn't stay awake any longer," Jeremy asked.
"Greybeard, will you tuck me in and read me a bedtime story?" "Tuck you in! Pirates don't tuck!"
"No tucking!"
The only thing they had to read was a map.
"Don't you have any books?"
"Books? I shouldn't even bother about a good night kiss. To ask about a good night kiss."
It wasn't easy for Jeremy to fall asleep without a bedtime story, but he was finally dozing off when a storm broke. Thunder boomed and lightning flashed. Jeremy tried to hide under the cover. The flames slammed up against the deck. Jeremy couldn't find anyone in the cabin. They're all on the...
"Lower the stairs! Batter down the hatches!"
Everyone ran around yelling, lowering, and batting. Nobody had time to sit close to Jeremy and tell him to be an officer. Nobody even noticed him.
"I don't want to be a pirate anymore."
Just then, flash, crack, crack. Lightning hit the mast and put it right down the middle.
"What should we do now?"
"We'll have to turn back."
"But the treasure! Where will we bury the treasure?"
"Maybe I can help. I know the perfect digging spot."
After the storm, they rolled back to shore and buried the chest. They drew a map so they could find the chest again. The journey to the beach would need it.
After that, I repaired the ship and got ready to set sail. Before that, Redbeard handed Jeremy a flag and said,
"You may be fine pirate, Jeremy Jacob. Guard the treasure well. We'll be back to get it soon enough."
"Soon enough!
And if you ever need us, on the Jolly Roger up yonder pole."
"Up yonder pole!"
"And maybe I will, but not today. I have soccer practice."
Say hi to your mom.